Tonight, exclusive, Jim Carrey and Jenny McCarthy, partners in life and partners in the search for answers to autism.
Yesterday, the world was World Autism Awareness Day. You both must be encouraged by all that's happened to in this subject since you literally started it.
Yeah, you know, we've come a long way within the community. When I first had Evan diagnosed with autism, there wasn't much of anything. I had to find out about biomedical treatment on the internet after I typed in autism on Google. And out 3 years later now, there's three books and many thousands of children getting better because of biomedical treatment.
Jenny brought so much focus to this problem. And kind of that's why I'm here, is I want to bring as much focus as we can to this problem.
You married autism. You're not married, so you live with autism.
When I invited Jenny into my life, I invited Evan into my life. And when I first met Evan, he was like he was on another planet. I wasn't in the room. There was no eye contact. There was no response to dialogue. There was no affection. And over time, I witnessed Jenny pull Evan through the window of unconsciousness and isolation into our world, where he is now a fully functioning person who can communicate, who can connect, and this is through biomedical treatments, GFCF diet, and the therapies that she's talking about. So I believe that autism, in my heart, is preventable.
And treatable.
Fully functional.
He's completely recovered, Larry, completely recovered. And he's not the only one. There are thousands in this community that are getting better.
Why did you go so public? I mean, you had an autistic child. He got better. So why are you here?
I could have, you know, hid and not said anything, and Evan would have blended into society. I made a pact with God, though. The day Evan became diagnosed with autism, I said, if you show me the way, God, and show me how to heal my boy, I will continue to teach the world how I did it. And within 1 year of that kind of conversation with God, Evan was undiagnosed from autism.
But it's still shocking to see how many people are ignoring this information.
The American Academy of Pediatrics, I begged and have sat down with and said, why are you not sitting down with our doctors and our scientists who are treating and recovering children with autism? And they refuse to this day to sit down.
If there was any possibility that a child was being helped, that someone would listen, someone would take a look. And the fact is, they're not even considering the information. They're not only not considering, they're discouraging it.
But you've had a major effect. Big story in the LA Times last week.
Mm-hmm.
Number of kids not being vaccinated in public schools in Los Angeles. However, at the same time, a doctor friend told me today, mumps are up and measles are up.
We're not saying don't vaccinate. That's the thing we want to get really clear
Let's make it clear.
Yeah, this is the thing.
There's a lot of misdirection going on. We hear the Campbell Browns and people like this that are saying, you know, you can't not vaccinate. No one has ever suggested not vaccinate.
Go back to the 1989 schedule when shots were only 10 and the MMR was on that list. I don't know what happened in 1990. There was no plague that was killing children, that we had to triple the amount of vaccines.
What happened after 1989?
And why did they triple?
That warranted 26 more vaccines.
Greed.
Are all of them absolutely necessary?
Because they want to make money.
Of course. Okay. Back in 1989, the shot schedule was 10 shots given.
10 shots given.
When I was a kid, what do we get, 3?
It's twice as many as anywhere else in 30 countries in the Western world.
But
We give twice as many shots as any of those countries. Why is that?
If it's vaccination and you're not against vaccination,
right?
Well, what are you against? Don't vaccinate for this, but vaccinate for that?
Yes.
I think we have to choose which ones are absolutely necessary.
You should educate yourself. We want to empower parents to educate themselves. Do we need to have the chickenpox? Do we need the hepatitis B shot on the second day of life?
I don't think we can afford to assume that the people who are charged with our public health any longer have our best interests at heart all the time. Parents have to have to make their own decisions. Educated decisions. They have to look at the information.
Space out the vaccines. Delay them till after one. Clean out the toxins that are in them. We don't need that many.
When the other doctors are here, and they will be on the other side in a while after you leave.
Grab them and stab them, you mean?
That was one.
This is my nickname.
Well, what will
them.
They say? Why would a doctor not want to know more about something that could save a life or prevent a disease? I don't understand.
The AAP is financed by the drug companies. Medical schools are financed by the drug companies. This is a huge business. Vaccines are the largest growing division of the pharmaceutical industry. $13 billion.
They control medical schools. These doctors are not learning about prevention or vitamins or diet.
What we're asking is for them to take a loss for the good of our children. That's a tough sell in a boardroom.
And for, you know, as a precautionary measure right now, you know, you remove certain medications off shelves because they're deemed unsafe. Why not vaccines?
Healing and Preventing Autism, A Complete Guide, Jenny McCarthy and Jerry Cardinale, MD, by the way. And we're joined now by Dr. Jerry Cardinale and J.B. Handley, co-founder of Generation Rescue, a nonprofit autism research and treatment advocacy group. In February, a special vaccine court ruled in three test cases representing 5,000 families that the combination of thimerosal, is that right?
Thimerosal.
Containing vaccines and the MMR vaccine are not causal factors in the development of autism. How do you react?
Our kids get 36 vaccines. The MMR is two of the 36 shots, okay? Before their first MMR vaccine, they get 23 other vaccines. Jenny, can you pull up the visual for just a sec? This shows very quickly how many vaccines children get at their two-month visit, their four-month visit, and their six-month visit. 23 vaccines before the first MMR. Saying that the MMR
vaccine... every child in America.
Every child in America. This is the CDC schedule. Saying that the MMR does not, or that vaccines do not cause autism because of this one vaccine, is like having a plane crash, suspecting mechanical failure, looking at one wing, saying that one wing is safe, so therefore the whole plane is safe. It's madness.
When I trained in medical school, we saw one child with autism, and they said, Dr. Cardinale, come look quick. There's a child with autism. You'll never see one again.
So it was rare?
It was very rare.
So are you saying it's increased?
I am definitely saying it's increased.
Because?
Well, because I think there's a lot of toxins out there that are in the environment. I think the bloated shot schedule now that we have. You know, we're asking women to get a flu vaccine at 6 months. And the flu vaccine's never been shown to be safe for fetuses. And yet we're going ahead and asking our women to take that.
We looked at 30 other first world countries, okay? We sorted them by under five mortality rates. The U.S. is 34th in the world for under five mortality. We looked at the average number of vaccines given. It was 18. The top five countries have 11, 13, 11, 11, and 13 vaccines given. So I would tell you, either go back to the 1989 schedule before this whole mess happened, or go to Finland's schedule, Sweden's schedule, Norway's schedule, and use theirs.
But because their autism rates... Why doesn't the rest of the world follow to us?
Their autism rates are one-tenth of ours. We welcome people doing the measles and mumps shots.
You want the measles and mumps.
Absolutely.
Vaccinate for the measles.
So people are overreacting and canceling that vaccine.
Correct.
Absolutely. And vaccinate for polio. That's
obviously
on the 89 schedule.
But things like the rotavirus, which is a diarrhea vaccine, we say, really?
You have access to clean water and health care, it's very difficult to die of diarrhea.
Dr. Cardinale, are you an outcast in the pediatric community?
Well, definitely. You know, even just the idea of prescribing vitamins or minerals or cod liver oil, the idea of taking an autistic child who's not sleeping the whole night, who's in pain, who's got a bloated belly because of constipation, saying, you know, he's not doing willful stool-holding behavior. He's constipated. Let's fix it. Let's take care of the pain. Other doctors aren't doing that. What about the child who's got chronic diarrhea? Why don't we fix that? Why do we have to say that when they have autism, we don't
have to... Are you saying other pediatricians don't want to learn this?
Absolutely.
Don't want to learn it.
In fact, I happen to bring this right here. This is last month's Journal of Pediatrics, and in it, there's an article written that says, Autism Medical Home, a physician survey would show that doctors do not want to take care of autistic children. They don't want to learn about...
Don't want to take care of them.
No, they don't even want them in their clinic, okay?
That's the journal.
First page,
unbiased opinion.
And you see a big full page.
For the rotavirus.
Mary, two of 30 countries in the first world took this vaccine on besides us. The patent holder for the vaccine...
Is on the committee to choose the vaccine for children.
We know with conviction that vaccines cause brain injury. It's on the Health and Human Services website. So we're looking for something that's caused this epidemic. It went from 1 in 10,000 in the 1970s to less than 1 in 100 today in many states. The AAP truly never looks. They've never talked to Jenny. They've never talked to Dr. Jerry here. He's had dozens of children in his practice recover.
They're saying to these parents, we don't have any answers, we're not looking for any answers, and please don't look for your own.
And they're not offering any hope, and we are.
Today, I am not the celebrity. Today, I am a mom of a child who had autism, who has a voice that is willing to shake the ground of those responsible until all of our children are safe from harm.